Amartya Sen chair at LSE. A new frog species being discovered. What is a mud volcano? These are the things that we're going to talk about today. Welcome to Morning Tales. My name is Anuj Jindal and let's cover the Morning Tales for April 23rd, 2019. The first question that I have for you is, NASA has detected first molecule to ever form from stray atoms in the universe. What is it a combination of? It is a combination of which all elements? Let's have the answers in the comment section below, which before I tell you the answer myself and the reason behind it, what exactly is a stray atom, what exactly is a molecule, how has it been discovered, and what is the importance of it, all these things. So let's have the answers in the comment section below. Well, the answer to this question is C, helium and hydrogen. So helium and hydrogen were considered to be two important molecules because they were behind the proof of the Big Bang theory. So when scientists came out with the Big Bang theory, they said that after the Big Bang, helium and hydrogen should have combined to make a molecule called as helium hybrid. But they could never find this helium hybrid. But it's for the first time that they've found this particular molecule in the universe, and that is why this becomes so important. Now the question in the examination can be based on helium hybrid, it can also be based on helium and hydrogen, and therefore you need to remember both of them. Some important information that's been presented here, whatever has been important I have already discussed with you. Let's come to the second question quickly. The question says, who has been honored with the chair in inequality studies by the London School of Economics? A very important question and very important information behind the man who has been named for the chair. So the name of the chair is Amartya Sen Chair in Inequality Studies, and the purpose is to honor the Nobel laureate. So the answer is B, Amartya Sen. Some important information about Amartya Sen from where questions can be created. Well, two important informations that I can think of now. Number one, he won the Nobel Prize in Economic Sciences in the year 1998. What was this Nobel Prize for? Well, this was for his contributions to welfare economics and social choice theory. This is something that you need to understand. Details about his contribution, details about his social welfare theory for another time. Another important fact that you need to remember is about Bharat Ratna. So he was awarded the Bharat Ratna in the year 1999. So that's something that's important for us to remember. I hope you have noted down these points. Let's come to the third question. Where is the Mount Agung volcano located? Well, let's have the answers in the comment section below before I move on to the next question. The answer to this question is D, Indonesia. Brief look at different kinds of volcanoes that can be asked in the examination. Chances are very less, but you can have a brief look. Other famous volcanoes in Indonesia are Mount Bromo in East Java and Mount Merapi in Yogyakarta. We will also have a look at the entire list of all volcanoes in Indonesia, which, believe me, are a lot. Volcanoes in India can be divided broadly into these three types: active, mud, and extinct volcanoes. Well, active volcanoes are the ones which are most destructive, and the Barren Islands in Andaman and Nicobar Islands is famous for active volcanoes. Mud volcanoes are very much like active volcanoes, the only difference being that they are not so destructive, so whenever they erupt, then the mud slurries, water and gases come out slowly compared with active volcanoes, and they can also be found in Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Baratang. Some extinct volcanoes in the country: Dhinodhar Hills in Gujarat, Dhosi Hills and Tosham Hill in Haryana. These are famous for extinct volcanoes. This is a list, a comprehensive list of all volcanoes in Indonesia. Don't worry, you don't have to remember all of them. The only one that's important has been discussed because it was in news. And Mount Merapi, or Volcano Merapi, is this one here, as you can see. And Agung is here, this you can see here. So these are the important volcanoes in Indonesia. A lot of them very popular for its active volcanoes, and which create a lot of destruction though in the country, but still they have to deal with it. Let's come to the next question. Very important: when is Global Earth Day observed or celebrated? The answer, let's have in the comment section below. It's very important. The answer is C, 22nd April. The theme for this year's Earth Day 2019 was Protect Our Species. And as Vox has put it, 7 important pictures of Earth Day 2019. You can go through them as well. Some important ones that I found very enlightening, and I thought I would share them with you. The second one was plastic is increasingly not fantastic. And the data that they gave was that a pregnant sperm whale was found with 49 pounds. Believe me, 49 pounds, that's almost 25 kgs of plastic in a stomach along the coast of Sardinia in Italy. That was the amount of plastic that she had taken into her while swimming. Similarly, another whale was found with 88 pounds of plastic. That means almost 44 kgs. That's a lot of plastic. And this shows that we are dumping so much plastic into the oceans. Another important one was that amphibians, like the frogs, which are called sentinel species, are important because scientists believe that if there is any change in the environment, then these species are the first one to observe those changes. And therefore, if you are observing these species, if you are experimenting continuously over these species, then we know whenever there is an alarming situation. And the scientists have seen that a lot of these amphibians, a lot of these frog species, in fact, are dying because of deadly fungus that is coming up. This shows that something bad is happening in the environment. And at the same time, another picture showed that some new amphibian species are also coming up. Some new frog species are also coming up, which shows that the Earth, that our Mother Earth, has the capability to recuperate from whatever disasters we are actually doing upon it. But at the same time, the recovery is not as fast as we want it to be. And with the rate of destruction that we are going, it is believed by scientists that by 2100, that is almost 80 years down the line, the temperature of Earth would have risen to 4%, risen by 4 degrees Celsius. That would cause a lot of destruction in the entire universe, in the entire world. Let's come to the next question. What is India's rank in Index of Cancer Preparedness 2019, prepared by Economist Intelligence Unit? The answer to this question is B, 19th. A total of 28 countries were observed under this Economist Intelligence Unit, and India got a rank of 19, which is not so great. Globally, first rank has been achieved or observed by Australia with a score of 90.6. That is something that can be asked in the examination. And all the remaining four ranks, top five ranks, other than the first one, have been taken by European countries. That means the amount of research, the amount of focus that they have on cancer is unbeatable. So that shows the amount of work that we need to do with this new disastrous disease that is coming up and affecting a lot of people around us. Okay, so that was all for current affairs for the Morning Tales of 23rd April 2019. If you like this lesson, which was short and sweet with some important information, you can subscribe now, and don't forget to press the bell icon if you do subscribe. I'll be back tomorrow again with some more quizzes, with some more current affairs for you. Till then, all the very best. Take care.